know you guys didn't see me in so long, but I'm here to do a little update on my life and tell you guys what's going on. So as y'all can see, this doesn't look like my room because I'm not home. I'm in college and I live on campus right now, so I've been so busy with school and all those things going on. Finals is literally starting Tuesday, so I've been so stressed, but I took a break from studying, so I said let me make a YouTube video. I didn't make a YouTube in a video in so long. So many people kept asking me to make a video, so I'm finally here. Last time you guys checked in, I had a boyfriend. I am single again, back on the prowl. Okay, so I'm single and right now I've just been focusing on school. Did I tell you guys that I totaled my car? I'm fucking carless, pissed off about that, so upset. Let's see, what's new. Yeah, I just been chilling. My midterm grades were so great and I'm scared for my finals, very anxious. Christmas is coming up, happy about that, trying to get a new car for you guys. And yeah, but there is something that I've been meaning to address. Everybody's always like, oh my god, that girl has no friends, like never trust a person with no friends. Oh my goodness, this girl doesn't have any friends, like she's always by herself. Oh my god. And let me just address that real quick. Okay, I have friends, they're just not females. All my friends are mostly guys and I love them to death and they'll do anything for me. That's one. Two, mind your business. Three, females are very much weird, okay? My whole life I ain't had friends since pre-K, okay? I never had them. Never cared for them, never wanted them, never needed them. But since people are always, you know, saying shit, I am going to tell you guys a story about a friend, okay? So, I met this girl on social media, whatever, and we found out that we both lived like in the same area. So we started to hang out. Let's call her Pearl. So we didn't hang out too much, but like since we lived close, like I came to her house before she came to mine, whatever the case may be. Pearl was real cool. I thought she was fly. I thought she had her own stuff or whatever the case may be. She told me that she was pregnant. She had a baby, you know, god mommy here. And all that. So one day Pearl comes to my house, and this is like at the time I have a boyfriend. I don't really remember exactly what month, but she came to my house, y'all. Okay guys, had to put the phone on the charger real quick. So Pearl comes to my house and I had cooked that day, fed her, everything's fine, we're just chilling, hanging out, talking. So like I call my boyfriend, my ex now, my boyfriend at the time. And I'm like, let's go out. Like, I'm with a friend. Like, because usually I'm not really with friends. Like, and like his friends always asking me for friends. I'm like, I don't have a friend. But today I finally got a friend. So, what's up? Let's go outside. So, I'm thinking, like, everything's cool. Me and my friend are cool. Like, we about to be lit. We about to have mad fun. Like, I did her makeup. I did my makeup. Like, we're outside. Thinking about it now, like, I didn't realize it at the time. Like, I'm thinking, like, she was just anxious to leave. She didn't say like, oh, I want to leave, I need to go home, but like she was like before we had made the plans, she was like, oh, I should go home, like I'm tired, like the baby, whatever. She telling me a whole bunch of stories about the baby, about the baby's father, he's so in the baby life, the grandmother is in the baby life, everybody loves the baby, whatever the case may be. So okay, cool. So we go out, we have fun. I'm about to see if I could even find a video for y'all of the night we went out. But yeah, we go out, everything's cool. So y'all, so the next day, so I go home, she goes home, whatever. My freaking poster just fell off my wall. We'll deal with it later. But okay, so we go home, I go home, my boyfriend drops her home, everything's fine. I go home, just laying down, watching stories. and I see her with the outfit that I have. And I'm thinking like, oh, she got it. Because I'm not thinking nobody's going to steal from my house. I'm not thinking nobody's going to steal from my closet, okay? So I'm just watching her store. I'm like, oh, shit, I got that outfit. But then I'm like, hold on, let me look for it. Because my closet, it's a mirror closet, but it's always open. Like, I don't know, I just be leaving it open. Like, I be forgetting to close it. So it just be always open. And that outfit was on the top shelf. Like, you could clearly see it. Like, I could see it laying down on my bed. Like, I could see the outfit. Like, I could see the outfit. Like, so then I'm like, hold on. I'm looking for the outfit. Outfit nowhere to be found. I called her. I said, did you take my outfit? Like, you took my outfit? You stole from my house? Like, but I still don't want to believe it at the same time, guys. I really don't. She's texting me, on my son's life, I will never steal from you, Nia. Like, you know that. I will never do no shit like that. Like, why would you even think I would do some shit like that? I will come to your house and look for the outfit with you. So I'm like, okay, maybe she didn't steal. Maybe I'm bugging, you know? Like, maybe I'm bugging. I'm not bugging. That was my outfit on her goddamn story. I'm still looking for the video to show y'all that night. That was my outfit. And I'm just thinking about, like, wow, you went out with my boyfriend and everything. Whole time, my outfit in your bag? Wow. So, let's rewind. So, okay. I'm like, you know, I'm coming to your house. Like, I know you got my outfit. So, I come to her house. Her house is, like, a dead-end block. So, but she lived, like, on the last house. So I keep calling her, like, I went over there, like, I'm not playing. Like, girl, why would you steal from my closet? Why would you do that? So I'm not playing. Like, I went to the girl house. So she, like, oh, it's not over here. It's in Brooklyn, like, where my boyfriend had dropped her off. Because she, I guess, that's where her father lives. Or whoever lives. Whatever. I don't care. So I'm like, okay, my boyfriend's coming. He's going to take us to Brooklyn. We're going to see who outfit that is. She like, Nia, this is my outfit. Like, I'm going to show it to you, and you tell me if it's like yours. Mind you, I shouldn't even have said this, but I told her there was a stain on the top. So now when I'm at her house, she can't find the top. All she sees is the pants. The pants got holes in it. She cut up my pants. I'm going to show you guys the freaking outfit that... Guys, oh my God. This is the outfit that she took. An $800 outfit. $800 outfit. Look how cute I look in it. Like, are you serious? Are you serious? Why would you steal this from me? So, anyways, so we chilling or whatever. No, we're not chilling. What am I talking about? So, we're at her house and I'm looking at the outfit stink. Like, she didn't even wash the outfit. She wore it out the next day, went and got her makeup done, everything. So, I'm looking at her stories and I'm like, wow, she went and got her makeup done, all that, to go chill in somebody else's outfit. What type of bum stuff is that? So, you know what? So when I'm at her house, when she showed me the pants, or whatever, this girl starts crying, guys, saying, oh my God. On my son, Nia, I will never do that to you. Like, I swear to my kids, this and that. And I'm really thinking the girl got a kid. Y'all, oh my God. So I'm like, you know what? Maybe I'm bugging. Maybe I'm, because the girl starts crying hysterically. I swear to God, I put that on my little brother. I have a little brother, okay? That's for real. Anyways, so I'm like, you know what? Maybe I'm bugging. I go home. I check again. I said, nah, this girl really stole my outfit. Because I misplace stuff. I do. I have a lot of clothes. So I do misplace my stuff. But I'm like, I'm not bugging. Mind you, the outfit still didn't pop up till this day. That was my outfit. I didn't even take the pants back or nothing. She had holes in it. It was stink, everything. So come to find out, let's fast forward a little bit. Like, I think a day later, I'm like, nah, this girl really stole from me. So I aired her on Facebook. Coming to find out, she's always stealing from people. She stole some girl whole Montclair. She stole some girl panties. The girl doesn't even have a baby. She doesn't even have no kid. So whatever kid she was putting everything on was a whole lie. Because she has no kid to put nothing on. And this is exactly why females are weird. And this is exactly why I stay to myself. And I'm happy like that. No nigga, none of my guy friends is coming to my house and stealing my fucking outfit. Okay? Niggas are not doing that. I can't trust females. I have weird stories about females for days and days and days and days and days and days and days. But that one stood out the most. The weirdest thing ever. Like, so weird. But you know what? Since we're on the topic of weird females, to prove my point, I'm gonna tell y'all another story. Okay. This is just weird stuff. This girl wasn't my friend or nothing. It was just weird. So this girl has me on social media, replies to all my stories. I'm so pretty. Oh my God, this, that. Me and my boyfriend is so cute. This, that. This is not my ex now. This is my last ex. Oh my God, he was in jail at the time. So she's like, oh my God, like, I hope he comes home for you. Like, oh my goodness, like, you guys are so cute. She was posting videos of us on her story. Like, they are so cute, couple goals, this, that. So, when he came home, right? We and him had broke up, whatever, we fell out, whatever the case may be. She started talking to him. God, strike me if I'm lying. And not sneaky talking to him or nothing so I don't find out. She was posting on his wall. Like, literally posting on his wall. Like, he's not even responding or paying her no mind. She's literally posting on his wall. Weirdo. See how weird females are? Do you guys hear me? Can you hear me? Like, can everyone hear me right now? This is the weird stuff that I have been encountering forever. I have so much weirdos. I've encountered so much weird people in my life, y'all. Y'all don't even understand. And this is why I have no female friends. And this is exactly why I stay by myself. And this is exactly why I'm happier by myself, okay? Should I tell you guys one more? Because that one's pretty short, right? Let me see. Do I have another one? I do have another one, but like, I don't want to get too into details and then people start saying, oh, you talking about me on your YouTube. Girls start hitting me up, oh, that was about me. I'm weird. You talking about me. Like, I don't have time for that because, you know, they will do that now. But let me see. Let me think. I don't know. Okay, guys, one more. And that's it, and I'm done. This is the last story I'm telling y'all about the weirdos I've encountered in my life. Okay, so me and my ex, when I was younger, maybe like 17, 18, we used to break up a lot. So when we break up, he would talk to girls, stuff like that. It was very, very much toxic, okay? So this one time, he started talking to some girl, whatever, right? And it was some girl who didn't like me, cousin. I don't even know why the girl didn't like me. Actually, let me tell y'all from the beginning. Okay, we had broke up one time and he was talking to her. So I guess, then we had got back together. So I guess when we had broke up again, I guess they became friends now. And mind you, when they were talking, I read the messages. She kept talking about me, like, mind you, she had me on Facebook. I used to like my stuff. I thought we were cool, like, you know. But she was talking about me in the chat, like, you need to stop hanging out with your little bitches. You need to stop dating little bitches and fuck with a big body like me. Like, I'm a big body Benz, like, pressure. Mad throwing salt on me. For a nigga that had my whole name tatted, but that's besides the point. Anyways, so we got back together, we broke up again. So I guess she put him on to her cousin or something, I guess. So I guess he was talking to her, like I remember, like, he went live and, like, they were commenting and flirting, whatever the case may be. I didn't say nothing at all, not to nobody. Whatever he chooses to do is his business. Okay, I'm not arguing with no girl over no nigga, period. So, and I already knew that they were trying to be funny and make me mad and want a reaction out of me. That's lame, okay, period. So, after that, we had got back together. It was an on and off toxic relationship. We probably shouldn't have got back together, but we did. So we had one live together, whatever. Her and all her friends and a cousin, everybody started commenting, laughing. LMFAO, Elijah, you so funny. Wasn't you telling me to go fight this girl, this dad? You were saying you don't even fuck with her, blah, 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 blah. Just commenting on that. And I'm just like, wow, these girls are weird and stuff like that. And then they started talking about me and one of my friends at the time. She's not my friend no more. But that's just another story. That can be its own video because that is some craziness. That was like my best friend. But we don't talk no more. Anyways, so... yeah, so it's big drama now, just that they mad at me for a nigga that was been mine. Weird. Okay, so So then it was just big beef, like just me and the girl was always arguing, and the girl was talking about me and posting about me, was posting about the girls, mad back and forth stuff on Facebook, so much drama, a bunch of unnecessary BS. And then, like, me and the girls arguing one day. Let me tell y'all what this weird girl said to me. She said, "Nia, I will put you on the floor and spit in your mouth." Girl, you would do what now? What? How you even say that to somebody? You should be ashamed of yourself. Like, you're disgusting. What do you mean? What do you mean by that? Like, I'm confused. What do you mean by that? Weirdness. So, therefore, I will stay alone. Okay? Thank you. Whoever's meant to be in my life will be in my life. And whoever's not meant to be in my life, God will remove them. And I just feel like that's how every friendship in my life ended. God didn't want them in my life. They didn't belong. I'm never the problem. And I can admit when I'm wrong. Don't think like, oh, you know. I can admit when I'm wrong. But in those three different situations, I did nothing to these females except for live my life. Girls are weird, and that is why I stay alone. Okay? People be like, oh, she's weird. She don't got no friends. Or never trust a girl with no friends. I don't trust you girls with friends. Because imagine how much, okay? How about that? I don't trust y'all. Okay? Period. But I'm happy I gave you guys a little life update. I'm going to try to post a little bit more. I'm loving the blonde hair. Like, a bitch is a gun. And, yeah, I'm just going to keep trying to post. Keep trying to do things like... like, comment, and subscribe on my video. Period. Don't forget that. And yeah, y'all know the vibes. I changed my Instagram too. It's now Big OG, BigOhGee. Okay, follow me. And period. Mwah.